indecisive, queasy? Are you a stumbler in the dark, flailing your arms, hitting your head against unseen walls? Relax, Beth. Take it easy. No more indecision, no more guilt. Life made simple. Join us as we play the dream of your choice, Morality Made Easy. And here's your host, Ramon!
Good evening, good morning, good grief, good gosh, good gosh, oh my heart, diggity dog! Come on in, sit right down. We're here, you're there, and our contestant, Beth Ann Shumway, is on the spot. Say hi, Beth Ann.
Are we on?
We're always on, dear. That's one of the problems. Life just won't let up. Really, Miss Lowenthal.
It's just one darn thing after another.
But we're here to take away all that trauma. Won't that be wonderful?
Yes, it will, Ramon.
I bet you're glad you came to join us.
Yes, I am.
Now, about those rules. Millions and zillions of them. Far too complicated to understand. If we understood the rules of life,
we wouldn't have to play the game.
The game she is simple. Five fun-filled rounds, each more pleasant than the last. Each hinging on you unhinging. The contents. Now, and after each round, we'll do up to the old anxiety-o-meter to see just how far you've come and how fast you can reach nirvana. Or as we like to call it, okie-dokie land. Now it's time for the first preliminary reading. Ms. Lowenthal, if you would do the honors. A 9.5? For heaven's sake, Beth Ann, get away from that thing. What in the world is causing all that trauma?
Huh?
This is where you tell us about yourself.
Oh, well, I work in a hospital in a cancer ward. I counsel families of dying patients. God, that must be terrible. Yeah, it's really depressing. How do you get through it all? I don't. Most days.
Okay, on to round one. International Falls. It's time for you to buy a new car. Do you buy Japanese for a better performance record? Or American to support the home auto industry?
Japanese?
All right, Ms. Lowenthal, let's see if you got this time. Me, Dave Armstrong.
Thank you so much, Beth Ann. Because of you, my dad's spoiled us to stay open. Thank you so much, Beth Ann.
Very nice, Beth
Ann. Very nice, Beth Ann.
How do you feel?
I feel pretty good.
Pretty good. Ladies and gentlemen, she feels pretty good. Well, how good is pretty good? Let's test it out scientifically with Mr. Meter. 7.5. Very nice, Beth Ann.
Very nice, Beth Ann.
Looks like you're on the roll. On to round two. Funding Mania! Out of these two items, which do you support? Providing basic ranch to college students, or providing daycare for lower-income working moms.
I guess I'll provide the daycare.
All right, who have we got? Jolene Gudge!
Thank you, Beth Ann, for thinking of us. Thanks to you, I get to keep my job at the Tasty Freeze, and one Sue gets to keep going to the daycare. She seems excellent looking after. And I still have money left over to buy new tires. Thank you so much, Beth Ann.
Oh, I feel so warm and wonderful. How about you, Beth Ann?
I feel terrific.
Really?
And what's Mr. Meter telling us now?
It's a good one. 5.5. She's heading straight for okie-dokie land.
That's amazing. You're happy, I'm happy, Beth Ann's happy, Jolene's happy, Dave's happy. The guys in the booth are happy. The parking lot attendant's happy. One big happy family. On to round three.
Everybody?
Sure. Round.
Ramon, can I ask one quick question?
I wouldn't if I were you.
I was just wondering, is that girl going to go to college now?
I believe you strain from our guidelines, dear.
No worries. Alone. I'm not really exactly. I was just curious.
What's that? We have a new project. You are indeed worried. Don't do it, Beth Ann.
Ramon, could I just, you know, check for a second?
What would Mr. Meter say?
I'll be right back. This will only take a second.
Every party has a pooper. That's why we invited her. Party pooper. Party pooper.
What's going on?
Oh, nothing much. Welcome to my nightmares. We're making it up as we get along. That Shumway, middle name, Hinselmeyer.
Hey, I was just wondering. Do you get to go to college now? I've already been for a couple of years of business. I've only got part-time because I had to work. At that rate, we're taking 8 years. So I quit and got a full-time job as a receptionist in the doctor's office. Are you going back someday? I doubt it. The job's okay. But you're probably not challenged. You can't have everything. This isn't fair.
Yeah, but I got a fiance. He's got a good job, so I'm a little excited.
I'll give you the prom.
Wait a minute. You gave the money to me.
Really? Can you really do that?
No, she can't.
If I hurry, I can register for some reception.
But what am I going to do with Wanda Sue?
Hold on, is she reading MS2?
It's her decision. She can do whatever she wants.
Indian giver?
Oops.
Oops, she said.
Ramon, I don't think I'm cut off for this.
Beth, you're thinking too much. The name of the game is Morality Made Easy. Not life so rich. Miss Lowenthal, paint her that picture when she makes it through all 5 rounds.
Mid-70s with a warm summer breeze, iced tea on the veranda, Sarah Vaughan on the stereo, reading the Sunday newspaper.
Now, when was the last time you read all the Sunday paper and didn't have to worry about what was in it? It can all be yours. On to round 3, hospital hijinks. At a famous hospital, the writing is on the wall. Funding is being cut back. Out of these 3 hot ticket items, which do you support? Heart transplants for adults, liver transplants for children under the age of 6, or Medicare supplements to keep up with the pace of living?
I can't do it alone. It hits too close to home.
We've been at this, what, Miss Lowenthal, for me 8 minutes and already she's pulling out?
Where?
You know what happens to people like you? You become a misshapen, spineless idiot, incapable of making the most elementary decisions. Miss Lowenthal?
I am a misshapen, spineless idiot, incapable of even the most elementary decisions.
This man, like you, is paralyzed by thinking and caring too much. He could once decide which countries would get the bomb, if we supported the Nicaraguan contract, and who could or could not have an abortion. Now we can't even pick out the color of socks.
Wasn't that tragic, Bethan? He could end up with red socks and a brown suit.
I like that dress, Bethan.
Thank you.
It's a nice color. Actually, no, gray's my favorite color.
Oh, nice.
No, brown's my favorite. Black's my favorite. The color dress is
the same.
You see, you have to choose. Otherwise, it's a given. Miss Lowenthal, recapping round 3. Heart transplants, liver transplants, or Medicare supplements.
I want the largest chunk to go to Medicare because they paid into the system the longest. The second chunk to go to the kids' liver transplant because it's not their fault they were born with a bad liver. And I want the third chunk to go to the heart transplants because they seem to be having a lot of success with that recently.
Covered all those bases, huh, kid? Let's see who we've got. Means Benny Kincaid.
Yep, Dad, how can you do this? These hospital bills are going to kill us. Dad had insurance until they found out he had Hawkinson's disease and, well, let's just say they're not friendly anymore. And I'm trying to run a gas station by myself. And when Dad gets home, who's going to take care of him? Mom's got to work. We aren't quite to keeping up with the cost of living. The increase wasn't enough.
Meet Nadia Ivanhoe.
Hey, Bethan. Are you having a nice day today? Are you enjoying the bountiful spring we've been having? I don't mind telling you we're having a hard time at Ivanhoe home. In fact, we're not even at home most of the time. We're at the hospital with little Justin. And as you may know, he's awaiting a liver transplant. In the next 2 weeks, he doesn't receive a liver transplant. Like Mr. Kincaid, we're a little strapped for cash. The hospital was hoping to provide 6 free transplants this year. But as the money, it's a little too much. But we're still praying. I think I hear some chickadees outside. How lovely. How did I sleep at them?
And finally, Clarice White.
Bethann,
there's a drink. You can bring this cancer on yourself, please. Have you heard me talking about illness?